अतुल सर गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून जी, कैसे हैं आप?
बस बढ़िया सर, श्रीपद सर से कनेक्ट किया था अभी।
हाँ पता चला मुझे।
हाँ
कैसा रहा? वैल्यूएबल रहा?
वैल्यूएबल है, वैल्यूएबल है।
फैंटास्टिक,
थैंक यू सर।
नमस्कार सर।
नमस्कार सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी। गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून जी।
सौरभ जी, सॉरी आई कुडंट आंसर योर मेल, आई वाज बिजी ऑन वेबिनार। आई सॉ योर मेल बट दैट टाइम आई वाज बिजी विद द अदर वर्क।
नो इशू सर। गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून। आई विल गेट बैक टू यू आफ्टर दिस मीटिंग।
यस यस फॉर श्योर।
तो वेलकम शीतल, वेलकम मिश्रा जी।
थैंक यू
अतुल जी।
अतुल जी वो तुषार को मैं थोड़ा हेल्प करती हूँ, उनको कुछ लॉगिन में कुछ प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है। ठीक है
ठीक है, डन।
थैंक यू।
Bhunesh Thakkar ji, I have met first time to you on this portfolio.
Is it?
Yeah.
Good afternoon,
sir. Good afternoon, Bhunesh ji.
Bhunesh ji again is a discovery of the lockdown.
Oh. Bhunesh ji, let us talk something. I have already written on the chat box, every chat I'm writing till the time people, everybody, newcomers all join and they get used to my small brief. So I want to know something about Bhuvanesh ji.
Yeah, that is what this talk is all about. Today we'll be listening to him only.
True.
In fact, till then, you can tell something about yourself. We are at 2 minutes past three. So let us take another 3 minutes and then 5 minutes past three, we will start.
Sure.
Okay?
Sure.
Yeah.
I am Ishra. And now, let me tell you, ex-government, that I am forgetting now. No more government, ex-government. Government is my, in the genes, blood, whatever you say.
I see.
But at present, having one consultancy company, where I am CEO and I am looking after the consultancy work.
I see.
At present, everything is going online. I virtually from 14th of March, I haven't gone to office. And on 18th, I have left my all assistants to go back to their hometown.
I see.
If I would have not left, and not had vision that really after 22nd total lockdown will be there. They told, sir, this work, that work, I told this, all the work we will do from home. Things are going to be bad to worse. And so I am so happy that at least my boys, all the boys are safe and they are able to assist me. Here, if they would have been there, they would have not been able to do anything for me as well as for themselves.
Families would be worried.
Right. They are very happy. All young kids only. I had all the youngsters only. I generally take everybody as intern, as an MBA or engineer, and from the electronics and communication domain. Our one of the discovery was today in your channel with Satya, he came, Keshav.
Right.
Keshav Sharma, one yeah. boy was there. So he is also a gem of a person, young boy of 27 years, 28 years. And he is now with Satya. And the other guy, others are with me. But we are basically doing with almost all companies some work or here and there who can be named as telco A team or B team. B teams are all, A teams are only six, but B team is very big.
You mentioned telco mean you work in telecom space, sir?
Yeah. I have retired after 35 years of active service in Government of India and I have got experience in the, on deputation, I have gone to BSNL. I have been at the highest position. And then I was in the TCIL. And all the portfolio and countrywide, I mean the whole country I have traveled during my earliest till when I came to Delhi 10, 12 years back. And then thereafter I have decided I will live in Delhi only. Otherwise I was thinking I will settle in East somewhere. My preferred city was Kolkata. I'm like Bihar, but my hometown became Kolkata. But now it is Delhi for all purposes now, because now children's domain, I am now in children's domain and they will not leave Delhi.
We have been basically into system integration and trading. Initially we started with trading, then we entered into system integration and we are providing networking solutions and connectivity solutions. So
which all the company you have done, any public sector?
The work we have done for GAIL, Gas Authority of India, we have done a lot of work.
GAIL.
GAIL, yes.
Yeah. All good, right. Good. So good afternoon, everybody. Let us begin the interesting conversation. Today's conversation starts from A and it also ends with A, with a person whose name starts with B. Okay. So the conversation today is Ahmedabad to Africa. Okay. Our guest for the day is Mr. Bhuvnesh Thakur, an electrical engineer by qualification who worked for some company, who started his career as a customer support engineer. And later on, he thought that he wanted to have his own business. And that is where he got into manufacturing of components. And not only manufacturing, he also excelled in quality as well as in cost. That is what has allowed him not only to be competitive in India, also be competitive across the globe. Right now, they're already exporting to a couple of countries in Africa. So, Bhuvnesh, over to you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Bhuvnesh Thakur from Ahmedabad. I have my own business. Initially, we did networking system integration. I'll just give you my journey actually.
Yeah, that'll be awesome.
How we started manufacturing. So we were basically distributor of a company called MRO Tech Limited, which is a Bangalore based company. They used to manufacture line drivers and modems. And we wanted to be in data communication space right from the beginning.
This was around what year?
This is year 1996.
1996. Okay.
Yes.
So, do you know a salesperson at that time whose name was Ashish Sachdev?
He was not handling me. So, he was handling another region. So, I met only a couple of times.
Yeah. So, Ashish and me, we were college mates.
I see.
So, all right. Yeah, please.
Then MRO Tech became distributor of RAD modems. And RAD modems were the only high-speed modems at that point of time. And all internet service providers started offering their services and they were using RAD modems. So our business increased a lot during that time. Subsequently, we have been providing a lot of hardware equipment to internet service providers. And basically we were trading and giving a solution. One customer told us that he's facing a problem What they were doing was they were distributing internet by Ethernet. So they will bring fiber to the building. Then on the building top, they will put a media converter. So they will convert the signal from fiber to copper and then put a switch and distribute. Switch is like a normal networking switch which you use to network your computers. And they had to provide a local power. And that is where they were facing problem, because from the society, they have to give rent every month, 1,000 rupees or something. And without that, they will not get power and all. So they were facing a lot of issues with that. So they said that, why don't you give us a solution? Then we thought of a solution. We gave them a solution, but which was an external box solution. So there, customer was giving the power to the devices. Then we thought that why not build one device which will have everything in it itself. We don't have to have three different boxes. So I went around to China and many companies who are manufacturing Ethernet switches, that why don't you modify your design according to this? But nobody was interested, in fact. Then I thought, okay, let me manufacture it myself. We had no experience in manufacturing. We had no experience in design, nothing. Then we somehow managed to find a designer who could design a product for us. We discussed a lot what all things has to be there, how flexible it should be and things like that. Finally, we came out with a product, but because of our inexperience, we faced a lot of problem in sourcing components and also in getting it manufactured. Because normally in electronics manufacturing, you don't manufacture everything yourself. But there is a special process called surface mounted devices. So that assembly soldering is done by specialists on an assembly line. So you send your PCB and components out and they will solder it and give it back to you. So we could not find the right SMD manufacturer and things like that. We faced a lot of rejection in our manufacturing. And subsequently our cost was very high. But anyway, we started selling and our product started getting accepted in the market. We sent, some people from Delhi bought our samples and then they sent it to China for copy. And they got a very good copy at a very good price from China. Now we were in a dilemma what to do, because we have to match either China price or stop manufacturing. There was no choice for us. And we would have been out of business by that time. Then we thought of that, okay, we have to do something. So we started, we bought a couple of products from China. We studied that how they are able to offer at such a low price and why our price is high. And we basically studied that where we are making a mistake and why our cost is high. Because we have to eliminate all those reasons ultimately. So we studied those products. We found out, okay, they are using certain components, whereas we are using very high-end components, which was not needed. We just have to have a component which are just enough for the purpose. Then our sourcing has to be better. Then our production has to be better. So then I went to Amarotech. Amarotech had been manufacturing electronics since very long. So I went to their plant. They knew me because we have been their old distributor. And I asked them, okay, what are the things we have to take care of while manufacturing? Then for plastic casing also, I work very closely with my plastic casing provider, what material we should use and how to reduce the cost there. Ultimately, we reduced cost from a BOM cost of 2,000 rupees to 400 rupees. And that is how today we compete with Chinese switches ultimately. So this we had to do over a period of time, but
how long did you take to reduce it to this level?
Almost 2 years.
Okay.
And then we thought that, okay, when we are solving the problem here in India, there may be people who may be facing the same problem outside India also. Why not explore that possibility? So we participated in a couple of foreign exhibitions. We didn't get any inquiry for that matter, but we kept on pressing. We participated in JITEX once, no inquiry. Second time again, we participated in JITEX and we got one inquiry. And he bought a sample from there itself. And that was the breakthrough we were looking for. He was from Lebanon, actually. And he was an ISP. He liked the product very much. And then he said that, okay, I will become your distributor for Lebanon. Then we realized that, okay, how to crack the market. So he kept on buying. No, he kept first order. He gave first order of 100 numbers. Then he gave another order of 500 numbers. Now he's a regular buyer from us. And he's pushing our product in other countries as well. So he's pushed not only in Lebanon. He's distributing it in Lebanon. He pushed it in Turkey. He pushed it in Syria. Things like that. And Turkey, he helped us appoint a distributor. And Turkey distributor is now doing the largest business with us. Then we thought that, okay, we'll contact internet service providers first. We contacted quite a few internet service providers. They liked the idea, but their problem was, no, we buy locally, we don't import. So what to do? Then we hit upon an idea that, okay, we asked them, okay, from whom you are buying? Then they gave us the name of the guy from whom they were buying the locally, all the material. Then we contacted that guy and saying, why don't you buy my product? I'll give you one ready-made customer. Because that ISP was ready to buy, but he was not ready to import from us because he was not well-versed with import and all. Then that distributor agreed because that ISP also pushed him that, why don't you get these devices for us from India and things like that. And that is how it all started. And now we are using this strategy in almost every country to push, to enter, I would say. So first we contact ISP, then he gets convinced. Because see, one device as a sample, they can import. That's not a problem. Then they test it, then they like the product. Then they say, okay, now we want to import more, but our import is not our strength. We would like to get it locally. Then we contact somebody and say, okay, I'm giving you a ready-made customer. Why don't you become our distributor? Things like that. So that is how we entered into Africa. Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, we are already there. And the distributor there is quite happy. In fact, he's so happy that he organized a special exhibition only for our product. And he invited a lot of ISPs and showcased our product. And now our volumes have increased a lot in Africa. Only thing that we decided was that we will not compromise on quality. Just to reduce.
But today, how many units do you manufacture?
We manufacture at least 5,000 units a month.
Okay.
And out of which almost 3,000 are exported. 2,000 are sold in local market.
Wow. And so you have your in-house manufacturing for the entire product now, or you still outsource
SMD,
something?
No. The SMD manufacturing we have outsourced only because it requires huge investment.
Okay.
And our volumes don't justify it.
Okay.
Because, see, 5,000 numbers, I'll be able to manufacture in one day only. Then for 29 days, what will I use those devices for, those machinery for?
Okay.
So it's better to get it done outside. Because it requires special manpower and all. And it's a big botheration. You know, then you have to do a lot of job work for people and all. It's entirely different business.
Fantastic. All right.
I tell you,
so,
in fact, even Apple uses those kind of outside EMS. Apple themselves don't manufacture anything.
Right. So they use Foxconn a lot, right?
Foxconn. Then there's another company, I forgot the name, W. It starts with W.
All right.
Apple uses both. So,
fantastic. Now my question to you is, how many products do you have?
We have 8 models, actually. 8 different models. Depending on the technology that internet service provider
uses. But primarily the same product.
Primarily the same product. The idea is same, yes.
So don't you think that you are running a big risk?
No, we are upgrading our product. Okay, now we are entering into another area called home automation.
Okay.
So there you will be able to control all your gadgets, switches using your mobile at your home, plus security notifications. So that area we are entering into, again, it will be all manufactured in India only.
All right.
And, everything is indigenous. So there what we are doing is it's a big area, in fact. It can be used in offices, it can be used in homes. Suppose, I'll give an example. Say you have senior citizen parents. and you and your wife both are working and you are leaving them alone at home and you are always worried about their well-being. So we have a panic switch, which is a watch-like switch they can wear. And if they need any help, they just press the button. You get a notification that your parents need help on your mobile, wherever you are in the world. You may have gone to US or wherever. Then you can immediately contact your neighbor or somebody that, okay, parents have given me a notification. And even if you call, they are not able to answer your call because say, they might have fallen, mobile is away from them and things like that. What will you do? So you call your neighbor. The lock is electronic lock. You can open lock from anywhere in the world. So the neighbor will go to your house. You can open the lock and he can enter into your house and help to your parents. This is one of the example of automation, how it can help you.
Fantastic.
Secondly, it makes your life very easy. Suppose at the night, especially when you sleep, your AC temperature is 24 degrees or 25 degrees. But later you feel cold, you have to get up, reduce the temperature, and again go to sleep. Here, what we allow is we allow you to program that, okay, when you sleep 25 degrees, after 2 hours, it should be 26 degrees. After 2 hours, it should be 27 degrees, like that. So that your sleep is not broken. And these devices will automatically adjust the AC temperature based on the schedule. And in the morning, you can switch off at 5 o'clock and increase the fan speed and things like that. So this is how the automation.
So this product range is already available or are you planning to launch it?
It's already available with the Netstar brand.
Okay.
So this is another product range we are going into. This can also be very.
And how are you expanding this?
We will be appointing distributors and going ahead.
Okay, fantastic.
Secondly, I mean, you can even use it in offices. You know, in the evening, if you have installed our modules in every switch, in the evening, somebody will have to just, you know, switch off everything.
Right.
So even if somebody has, say, kept his AC on or whatever, will be switched off automatically. Nobody will have to go door to door and search and find out who has kept on and then switch it off. Especially in, say, executive cabins, which are locked by executive himself, he cannot go in and switch off the AC.
Okay, okay. So let us get into another piece. So, the products are interesting. Tell us something about... Tell us...
The best thing I learned about the whole thing is that everybody is thinking that we cannot compete with China. I disagree there.
If we
apply the right strategy and if we really work on our costs and find out how China is doing. See, China is not doing magic.
So what was the three top finding that you had through which we can contain costs or compete globally?
As far as my product is concerned, what I feel what people are doing is they are over-engineering their product, especially in design. Secondly, they don't keep trying to reduce the cost. That is the main reason the cost is high. Because once I have designed the product, then I say, okay, my cost is this. But you can always redesign the product to reduce the cost. First, find out, okay, what are the highest cost elements in your design? Then find out how China is doing it. Like say, I am using 4-layer PCB. They may be using a 2-layer PCB, which is cheaper. I may be using a particular chip, which is costlier for a particular function. In the market, there may be another chip available which is much cheaper for the same function. But I may not be knowing it. So once I look at the other people's product, I come to know that, okay, there is a chip. Normally, everybody's product will have a similar chip. So I just have to find out which chip they are using and find out price from the market and then find out that whether that chip I can use in my product also or not without compromising on quality and reliability.
Right.
But we could do it by searching for alternative suppliers.
And most of these chips, they again come from China or there are other alternate sources
as well? They come from China. China has built such an excellent ecosystem that at least we will take another 10 years to build that entire ecosystem. I will give an example. Say, I initially used a Texas Instrument chip to reduce voltage from 24 volt DC to 3.3 volt DC, which I needed.
Okay.
Now, what China is doing is, in China, they have a Chinese company which is manufacturing a similar chip.
Okay.
And they are using that Chinese chip. They are not using a Texas Instrument chip.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Texas Instrument chip is costing me very high compared to the Chinese chip. I can also use that Chinese chip. Now, if I use that Chinese chip, my cost will be lower.
Right.
Similarly, other components, they have designed and they have started manufacturing those components in China itself. And the local companies have designed those components and manufacturing it. So their cost is very low.
So what is your take on the ecosystem for electronic manufacturing in India? So there is some amount of manufacturing it has started.
I believe that we should not stop Chinese, just you know, like say stop everything. No, that is not the solution. Solution is slowly do the backward integration. Okay. Initially, you start assembling here. Then one and each and every component, you can slowly start manufacturing in India. You can't do it overnight. So you have to do it slowly.
So like if you look at the automobile industry, I think that is how they have done it, right? So okay. They started with CKDs and then they came with SKDs. Yes. And after that, they started indigenizing it. In fact, that was one of the conditions for the auto majors whenever they brought a model into India.
Yes.
But for example, if you look at Maruti, they created their entire ancillary units and they started passing on the technology to them.
Right.
Or like you are saying about assembly line. So brands like Nokia, they're manufacturing in India for some time.
Right.
I'm sure most of it is assembly.
Right.
But at least the plastic component, the outer shell, that is being manufactured here.
Right.
Right? And even the other so-called Indian brands,
right,
a lot of it is being done. In fact, we've got, I think Saurabh Khanna is here, who is from the CCTV space, CCTV cameras.
Mm-hmm.
So there also there is some amount of manufacturing which is happening in India,
right,
and the basic structure is being imported, and I think gradually we'll go up the value chain.
That is the way it has to go. We cannot stop suddenly that, okay, now we'll do everything from tomorrow in India. That's not possible. It's not practical and it's not possible at all. We have to go slowly.
But unless we have that direction, it will never happen.
Not only that, see, people have to change their mindset. They have to prefer Indian products. See, China has not learned overnight. Chinese, what they have done is, they have given preference to local products. They have given local manufacturers a chance to improve their products. In India, we outrightly reject an Indian product. That's not the case. We should help our Indian manufacturers to, improve their products. Even if it's a little lower performing product, we should buy and use and inform them that, okay, these are the areas where you need to improve.
So I've got another question. I've got another question which is not directly related to your business, but it is related to the region that you are from.
Okay.
So if we look at Gujarat mm-hmm. is among the most industrially advanced states in India.
Yes.
And if we look at the past 10 years, the development has increased much faster.
Absolutely.
Earlier, for the engineering goods, Ludhiana and Coimbatore were the hubs, and Rajkot was competing. Now, Rajkot is gradually becoming much ahead. So can you share some reasons or some insights? How is this happening? So what is so special that Gujarat is doing or the Gujaratis are doing, which maybe the others should pick up?
See, one thing about Gujarat and Gujarati I can say is, we feel, as a Gujarati, that we can do
that's
anything.
Fine.
First of all, we believe that we can do anything. It is only thing that is needed is our will.
Okay.
I am not doing it because I don't want to do it, but I can do it. That attitude has to be there in every Indian, for that matter.
Mm-hmm.
Because I believe that everybody can do anything. Only thing is, he has to first believe in himself and put in the hard work that is needed. In Rajkot, if you see, I have been staying in Rajkot, the engineering industry, the way they achieve their accuracy, even with hand, is tremendous. Even Jamnagar, for that matter, is famous for brass. And Jamnagar is giving a tough time to China in brass parts manufacturing, let me tell you. There are many people in Jamnagar who manufacture so precision, very well precision parts in brass and very small parts. all these, you know, Jetwar and all you find are ultimately manufactured in Jamnagar.
Okay, that's interesting. So, Jamnagar is also known for the Jugaad vehicles, right?
Not
is that exactly Jamnagar or is that Junagar?
Junagar, that is more Junagar.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah. But Rajkot also is, for that matter, is very famous for Jugaad kind of thing. They've got good engineering mind for that matter.
Okay.
And I would especially stress that there's a particular community, Patel.
Okay.
They are very hardworking. It's, that community itself is very hardworking. And, you know, I mean, I can say they can work 20 hours in 24 hours. Once they decide that, okay, I want to succeed. Like, okay. Atul Otto is one very good example. Atul Otto Automobiles in Rajkot, they are indigenously manufacturing rickshaws and all. After Bajaj, they are the second ones who are succeeding.
Right.
And they have done very well across India for that matter.
Yeah, indeed they have.
But ultimately, what we have to believe is this only, that we can do it and we should try it, but everybody has to support Indian manufacturers. That is very important.
All right.
Today, if I should always think that if there are two products available, one is an Indian product, I will buy Indian product. It may be a little inferior in quality, yes, but then I will contact that manufacturer and tell him that I have supported you, but I want you to improve your quality and still match the price of Chinese. It is definitely possible. How we stopped manufacturing is because we never supported our local people. And China supported local people. Even government has a very big role to play as such. Just recently, I saw a post on WhatsApp. In China, government provides proper infrastructure for the industry. We don't say that, okay, you provide us subsidy and all that. Just provide good infrastructure. Today, I will give an example. Freight in China is so cheap. Government is not subsidizing. Government has given such a good infrastructure that they are, the private freight service providers are able to offer very low freight. In India, it is very high. So these are the things we need to work on.
But I think in this space, there is a lot of things happening in India as well, right? If you look at past, again, 10 years, the road infrastructure has improved, the rail infrastructure has improved, the speedways have increased.
Yes.
And there is so much of transparency which is coming in. Yes. Are all these not steps towards the same?
They are increasing. Yes, the improvement is there. But to be frank with you, the pace has to be much more. The pace is very, very slow.
Okay.
It cannot be this slow. Then it will take very, very long time for us to catch up.
Right.
But yes, we are catching up. We are growing in confidence. All the manufacturers, not only me, I'm talking about all the manufacturers I see and meet and talk to, everybody is bullish now about manufacturing. So that way, it's a very, very positive environment and I'm very, very positive about our future.
And the current standoff that is there with China, what do you say about that?
Well, that's a passing phase. China has their own internal compulsions for which they have to, deflect their people's attention from some other problems. So they're doing it. Otherwise, there's no reason for them to do it. But I believe China will be paying a very, very heavy price in terms of, awakening India. I would say China is making the big mistake of awakening India. And India will be a formidable competitor to China if we just continue our momentum what we have right now.
Interesting. Yep. Any questions we have from the audience? Is the audience awake?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
No. It is so interesting. Actually, I have one question.
Yes.
Bhuvnesh sir, if new entrepreneurs are ready to establish their new manufacturing unit, so what requirement you need from them with your guidance, quality and all these kind of things, according to rate.
First of all, they have to spot the product what they will be manufacturing.
Okay.
And I always like the nano model. Okay. At what price I'll be able to sell in the market?
Okay.
And then will I be able to manufacture at such a price so that I can sell it at that price in the market? Okay. One is there is a product already, similar product already available in the market, and I'm manufacturing a similar product, then I already have a price reference. If, like say, for my product, I had no price reference because I was the first one to come out with that product. But there is always a law of economics that a customer will not buy my product just because my product is good. It has to be at the right price. Otherwise, he will not see any economical gain in buying my product. Then why should he buy my product? So he has to see some economic gain also that he is benefiting. If he is spending, say, 1,000 rupees, he is getting a value of 2,000 rupees. Then only he will spend that 1,000 rupees. Otherwise, he will not spend. So we have to understand that.
But
many people I have seen, they say that, no, people will pay. No, that will not happen. People will not pay just like that. Just because you fancy that it's worth 5,000 rupees, so people will pay 5,000 rupees. No. People should feel that it is worth 5,000 rupees.
Got it. Anybody else?
Thank you, sir.
You're most welcome.
Yeah.
Ravindra ji, aapka comment mein jarur chahunga.
Ravindra ji, on demand aagi ab to kahani.
Avashya, avashya.
Sir, experience itna bada hai ki he can guide us very well, people like us.
See, I tell you, see, your product is very suitable for all the system integrator even today. And now this system integration work is going on in every society, everywhere such equipments are required for aggregating the thing and then putting it onto net. So I also know many people in this field. Rather, I have been assisting them while sitting in the government and BSNL also for all the big players. I was thinking that after the meeting, I will get in one to one and share our old age time. Of course, now you have entered into the other domain from the service sector and quickly you have taken a decision and you have gone, really you have made it, but you have to go a long way and I wish that you go there. In North India, I will definitely be helpful to you. Let us establish in this sector, the sector in which you are there, from the any idea you have got which can be helpful in government sector to give them. I have done some helping in to many of the industry people, their products, it has to be enlisted in the list of priority sector for government, which all cannot be imported from any other country. It is to be Indian only. All this is very important for you also. And then what happens, you get a market for this one. So you can be, today you are already exporter, but I want that your product should be a preferred product and government should. Have you claimed the subsidy for the electronic manufacturing?
No, sir. Because we do EMS outside. So the level of which manufacturing that at our end we do is very less. So you're not
available. I think we will get in touch and then we will get you partnered with some more hubs. I have got a better knowledge. Only thing I have to also look for the people quickly and I'll get back. But I was very interesting when I was talking to you and when I came to know you are from our sector, telecom person, and having good knowledge from the service you have entered into. The
in fact, what we now look forward to is with this one particular product that we have been successful. Now we look forward to manufacturing a product which solves a particular problem. It can be in any sector, but that I'm confident now that I can very well succeed wherever I'm manufacturing a product which is solving a problem, number one, but it has to be at the right price. Then I don't think we can fail. We will always succeed solving a problem at the right price.
Your vast experience in this field, I am very happy to know, and now we will be one-to-one interact, and we'll go a long way. I think there is a lot of scope to further grow.
Yes.
And I think, okay, Saurabh, you about to say something?
Yeah, I just want to know that, first of all, congratulations, really appreciate the efforts you are taking for making India and promoting this to other countries as well.
It was a question of survival, so I had to do it.
That's good. I just want to understand if anybody want to start up, so what investment you have put in, because you said I am not actually manufacturing, I am getting it manufactured from a different company and then putting my expertise and making the finished product. So yes, anybody who can know from you what investment you have done in the initial level and what all expenses come across to be a real manufacturer.
See, first of all, you have to have a problem to solve, number one. Number two, you have to have right design. Then you have to design it very well. My product I could sell because of care taken in design. Because I'll give an example. See, I took care that, okay, who will install my product? So the guy who is installing my product in the field is going to be a low-end guy who doesn't know much about anything. Then how can I ensure that he doesn't make a mistake? So my design has to be such that he should not be able to make a mistake. Like say, our design is from the customer, cable comes and goes into certain ports and the output goes to from a different port. Now, if I put a normal switch, if you see, all the 8 ports are together. So he may by mistake put the uplink into the downlink. By mistake, right, he can connect, and that may create problem. So what we did was we put that port which was uplink separate, you know, a bit apart, say 22 centimeter apart. So there was a gap in between for 2 centimeters. So he cannot make a mistake. See, these are the kind of care you have to take while designing the product itself. But okay, what all are the problems that can be faced in the installation in the field? You know, and then when you incorporate such things in design itself, then I think your chances of success becomes higher. This is what is my understanding as of now.
Design has to be right.
But there are so many players who are into switching line, like D-Link, or probably Digisol, or probably Netgear.
Doesn't matter. See, today, D-Link is still able to sell their switches even at 700 rupees. And yeah, there is a switch available at 400 rupees also. But still, D-Link is selling at 700 rupees.
Gee.
So, I believe that everybody has a place. See, my product is not an ordinary switch. It's a different switch. So, D-Link doesn't compete with me. So, that's a different thing. But
so you are into giga switches or you are into normal unmanaged switches?
With 100 MB switches. Now we are planning to go with a gigabit switches.
So those are managed switches or unmanaged?
Unmanaged. Yes. But ultimately, see, that is where the problem is, especially the startups. They always think that people need my product. But they never ask people that whether they will need such a product, and if yes, at what price they will buy. So the first thing they have to do is, they have to do a survey that whether such a product is needed in the market, number one, and if yes, at what price. And then he should decide whether he will be able to sell at that price or not. That is very important.
And what type of investment initially you had to have? Just want a ball figure.
Say the investment I had to have was somewhere around 20 lakh rupees.
Okay.
Because design part and prototypes and all we have to get manufactured. Then some molds for plastic we have to get manufactured. Things like that. So the first model came out with 20 lakh investment.
And you got any government support in that particular thing?
No, my own funds.
Okay.
But 20 lakh at that point of time, which can multiply now at least by 20 times.
No, subsequently we had to invest a lot because we went into many other models, then many other enclosures. So we have to invest in plastic mold and all. because then only your product can sell. It has to be, see, my mold and all has to be so good that it should compete with the imported product.
Yeah.
You cannot say that, okay, my product, my plastic finish is bad because it's, I'm Indian. No, that's not acceptable to me. And when two products are set on the table, both should be equally good looking. That is also important. It's not that only the internal electronics that has to be good. The look also has to be top class, because the first impression is from the looks only. Working and all comes later. Even I face problem in packaging for that matter, because the cardboard box which I wanted, people say, no, we can't do it here. This is an imported box. I said, what? We can't manufacture even a cardboard box like this, which is good strength and thin. Then they say, no, we will need this kind of paper, that kind of paper. I said, get it. But I want this kind of box. I don't want to compromise even on that. Why should I? Because that is the first impression customer will have.
Fantastic. Any other questions or any other inputs? Okay, so tell us something about your family.
Well, I have a very understanding wife, supportive wife who supported throughout my journey. She was a newsreader on local Doordarshan channel, and she was an RJ also on All India Radio. I have two sons. My elder son did his MBA from IIM and is now working with Asian Paints Mumbai. My younger son did his industrial engineering and then he did his MS in US and he's now working in US. So that's what it is. I have two granddaughters who are very adorable.
So right now you and your wife are there in Ahmedabad, that's it, yes. Is it? Okay. I hope your kids are all well, your family is also fine.
He was with us till now, just yesterday only he went back to Mumbai.
Okay.
Because now his office is will be requiring his presence in office sometimes, not always.
So while you were building these products, I'm sure you would have gone through a lot of tension, a lot of uncertainty, whether the investment that you are making that will ever come back or not.
Right.
So at that time, what were the emotions you went through, and what is the kind of support that you got from your family?
To be frank with you, I had decided to hang my boots at 50. And thought that I will enjoy my life, relax. Then suddenly this manufacturing came and it became my passion. So now it is my passion. Manufacturing is my passion. So I'm doing it for hobby for that matter. So ab wo product becha aur China ke product ko beat karke becha, uska jo ek nasha hai na, wo nashe ke liye ab main karta hu. Baki kuch nahi.
Wo kitni dose roz lete ho is nashe ki? इस नशे की रोज डोज कितनी लेते हो?
रोज की कम से कम 150
विजय भूमेश जी को इस प्लेटफॉर्म पे डेली नशा मिलेगा, उसके एक एक डोज मिलेगी क्योंकि अतुल जी चार्ज करते रहेंगे एंड यहाँ पर इनके भूमेश जी टाइप के कई लोग हैं, अनफॉर्चुनेटली आज नहीं है लेकिन आज के सेशन में नहीं है, लेकिन वो लोग परमानेंट मेंबर हैं, वो आते ही हैं, पता नहीं आज क्यों नहीं आए इस सुबह में।
इवन भुवनेश जी यहाँ के परमानेंट मेंबर हैं, यहीं पर एक दिन जब हमने एक ऑफर डिक्लेयर की उन्होंने यहाँ पर यही बैठे बैठे जो पेमेंट कर दी, टंग करके मेरे को आवाज आई मोबाइल फोन में कि पैसा आ गया।
ग्रेट ग्रेट ग्रेट, तो बहुत ही बड़ी बात है एकदम तुरंत, क्योंकि मुझे भी थोड़ा टाइम लगा सोचने में क्योंकि मैं एक अलग डोमेन से ऑपरेट कर रहा था और अलग माइंडसेट का था, लेकिन थोड़ी देर के बाद में मुझे लगा कि एटलीस्ट इन यंग लोगों के साथ मैं भी तो यंग बनता चला जाऊंगा प्रतिदिन, तो आई एम रियली एंजॉयिंग दिस। राइट,
मेरा एक हॉबी है सर, मेरा हॉबी है एग्जीबिशंस विजिट करना।
ओके ग्रेट,
कम से कम वहां से बहुत सारी चीजें पता चलती है, टेक्नोलॉजी कौन से डायरेक्शन में जा रही है, नए प्रोडक्ट्स कौन से आ रहे हैं, लोग कौन से टेक्नोलॉजी की बात कर रहे हैं, उसके क्या एडवांटेजेस हैं, क्या उससे काफी कुछ पता चलता
है। एब्सोल्युटली, तो ये जो प्रोडक्ट इनोवेशन है वो आप ही का डिपार्टमेंट है या कि आपने कुछ और बंदे भी रखे हैं उसके लिए?
आइडियाज मेरा डिपार्टमेंट है, इम्प्लीमेंटेशन में सबकी हेल्प लेता हूँ।
ओके।
और अब तो मैं आइडियाज भी लोगों से मांगता हूँ, लोगों को पता नहीं चलता वो मुझे आइडिया दे जाते हैं, ऐसा होता है कई बार।
Fantastic.
जैसे मैं आपको पूछूंगा कि अतुल जी आप क्या प्रॉब्लम फेस कर रहे हैं, आप मुझे बताओ। आप अपना प्रॉब्लम बताएंगे, उससे मुझे आइडिया आएगा कि मुझे कौन सा प्रोडक्ट बनाना चाहिए। Kind of.
Fantastic. Awesome.
जैसे मेरा एक प्रोडक्ट मेरे दिमाग में है जो कि मतलब बनाना चाहिए, मगर वो मेरा डोमेन में नहीं है, इसलिए मैंने नहीं बनाया है या तो कोशिश भी नहीं की। क्योंकि मतलब मोबिलिटी चैलेंज्ड एल्डर्स स्पेशली,
राइट,
जो कि मतलब लंबा चल नहीं सकते हैं, थोड़ा बहुत चल सकते हैं घर में, 10-12-15 स्टेप चल लिया ठीक है, मगर लंबा चलना हो तो नहीं चल सकते हैं, एयरपोर्ट पे नहीं चल सकते, उनको घूमने जाना है तो क्या करेंगे, तो उनके लिए कोई मोबिलिटी व्हीकल बनाए, विच विल बी द नीड ऑफ द आवर एज ऑफ टुडे, आई कैन सी अ बिग मार्केट फॉर इट,
राइट,
बिकॉज नंबर ऑफ एल्डर्स आर इंक्रीजिंग।
But there are a lot of such units which are available, no?
There are, but none of them Indian, and none of them with lot of facilities.
Fair enough. और ये जो आपका home automation का जो range है, don't you think this is an area which is getting cluttered? Because there are white label products, there are branded Indian products, there are all kind of products so in this space.
Yes, sir, there are.
And also there is the challenge is that there is very little interoperability.
True. What you say is very much correct. I see it as a challenge, but there are many opportunities as well. Mm-hmm. See, because there are plenty of products, but they don't address everything. Number one. There is one Chinese company which has come out with an excellent idea and excellent architecture of their product, and they are doing very well across the world for that matter. But it's a Chinese product ultimately, and you are sending all your data to China. So today I see it as an opportunity that if I create a similar platform here in India, people will lap it up because nobody wants आपने अपना light कब चालू किया कब बंद किया वो भी China को पता चले।
Right.
अभी ये सिचुएशन है कि if I use that product, when I switched on my light, when I switched on my TV, what channel I'm watching on my TV, China will know.
Mm-hmm.
That's the situation. So and plus it
see, but this is a very there can be different perspectives to it. True. If not China, then Google gets to know it. If not Google, then Facebook gets to know it. Yes. If not Facebook, then Apple gets to know it. Somebody is feeding on our data.
Yes, but our strength is customization, sir. See, what happens is, suppose, say you are staying in a big colony. Now that colony wants to solve a particular problem. I can very easily solve that problem by simply tweaking my product a little and giving you that solution.
Okay.
Chinese is not going to give you that solution. He says, these are my products, so take it or leave it. We'll be offering it at a very low price. But he cannot do customization to suit your requirement. I can do. That is going to be the key differentiator.
But then this customization, does this not restrain your ability to scale up?
It will, yes. But at the same time, it gives me the strength to compete against China. Otherwise, I will not be able to compete against China so effectively.
Okay.
Like say, you know, I'll give an example. So the water meters will be very much compulsory very soon.
Yeah.
Across India. Mm-hmm. Now, what about the old societies? How will they implement water meter solution? Is there anything available off the shelf? Where will you put it? Because our pipelines are such that it is very difficult to put a water meter for individual. How will you do it? Finding a solution to that, something like that. So my automation will help there, and you can implement that water meters. Once it has to be implemented, it will be very easy to maintain also at the same time, measure also, do the billing, everything. Now, if I design a solution specially, it will sell.
Right. Okay, fantastic. Any other questions? So then what I'll do is I'll take a couple of minutes to talk about e-growth, about the CEO talks.
Go ahead. Yeah.
And then we'll again come back for a couple of questions. Just a moment. So CEO talks started on the 25th of March. Till date, we've impacted around 7,000 plus users, and it got unlocked during the lockdown. Every day during the weekdays, we have it at 3 p.m. The various topics that we've covered so far are sales, marketing, branding, learning development, industrial engineering, information technology, business automation, business opportunities, accounting and compliance, legal compliance, investment options, all the stuff, right? On Saturdays, we have what we call as the Industry Connect, wherein we have panel discussions on various topics which are relevant to the industry. We've had some of the associations and chambers who come and participate in these talks. All right. On Saturday, the talk that we have, that happens at 9:30 in the morning, not at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Just a moment. Okay. And then on Sunday, we have Chopal, which is wherein we don't talk about business. It is about general topics, how you we get to know each other better so that we are able to have better relationships. Our community partners are Empowerment Talks, Dubai in Institute of Digital Marketing, Thane, BBN Global, Nasik, Federation of Buying Agents, Delhi, Synergy Talks, Bombay, Lajja, Bombay, BNP Cafe again, Mumbai. Anva is there in Mathura, and Get Overbooked is from Delhi. All right. The people behind CEO Talks are eGrowth. eGrowth is the world's first BAD ecosystem. BAD stands for Business Advisory and Business Development. Our mission in life is to empower and enable businesses. We keep on looking at various aspects, how to support small businesses. The journey started in 2014, and right now we have around 30,000 users who are associated with us. Here are various images from various events that we had participated in the past. Okay. We went for a road trip to Punjab in 2017. We also went on a road trip to West India in 2017. We partnered with the Startup India for their Startup India Uttar Pradesh Yatra. There are some images from there. We also participated in a boot camp for the tribals in Jharkhand. There were 35 of them who started cultivating and then also exporting products. We've been doing other initiatives for entrepreneurship. So here are some images from Shimla, Udaipur, Kanpur. And also we did a bootcamp for Dalmia Bharat Group. We have also been having a flagship event called Celebrating Womanhood, which is for women entrepreneurs. This happens around the Women's Day, all right? We also launched a model called the Leverage Model, which is to help you design your business. Here is some media coverage that we've got in English, Hindi, as well as in Tamil. How is it that you can associate with eGrowth? Is that we've got a portal called eGrowth.org, and we have a social handle, which is eGrowth.org. We are there on Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, WhatsApp, Telegram. We do a lot of active engagement with the small businesses, which includes networking meetings, introduction to e-growth, CEO talks, buyer-seller meetings, delegation. So we also have something called as e-growth inner circle trainings and workshops. Last year, we did 3 buyer-seller meetings for Dubai Electricity and Water Authority, one in Delhi, one in Mumbai, and one in Ahmedabad. Okay. E-growth inner circle. Sanjeevji, are you there? Okay. Sanjeevji is the president of the e-growth inner circle. E-growth inner circle is an exclusive structure for B2B enterprises who have a pan-India or a global appeal. Sanjeevji, can you please take us through the inner circle? Sanjeevji, unmute.
Okay.
Yeah, please.
Inner Circle is a B2B structure and it's got handpicked members, around 30 to 50 members are there. And the average experience is 26 years. The main thing is that we have a create session in this. In create session, one of the businessmen talks about the challenges of the business. Then we resolve those challenges. And later on, we have an empowerment analysis, trust building, and all the apart from the create session, we have connects with industry connects, MSME connect is there, and Atul has got a lot of contacts with quite a few industrial associations. We get them on board also. Over to Atul.
Thank you. You can subscribe to eGrowth. The entry level thing is what is called as the basic subscription, wherein you get a verified profile, you can read write access to the portal, and you can also attend networking meetings. The second one is premium, wherein you can create your business profile along with your personal profile, and you get first degree contacts, and you can host networking meetings. And the top end is the inner circle, wherein along with the access to the online platform, you also get to meet every week. So since we meet every week, so that means 52 meetings in a year. You also get access to second degree contacts and industry connect, wherein we work with various industrial associations and chambers, and we build that further. Basic subscription, the benefits are curated network, privileged access, online engagement, offline engagement, do it yourself and pay as you go. This has a validity of 1 year and you are paying only 999 plus GST. Okay, so this is all what you pay. This is the lowest risk kind of a subscription. Even the not-for-profit organizations, they are not able to give you a subscription at this kind of a rate and with this kind of a value. All right, so you want to subscribe, you can go to egrow.org/basic-subscription. This was a little bit about the CEO talks. You can get in touch with us and we'd love to interact with you and help you further in your business. So thank you for your presence and thank you, Bhuvnesh ji. It was really awesome listening to you and really impressive to know that the manner in which you took the risk and you were somebody who wanted to retire at the age of 50, and after the age of 50, you have taken up getting into your hobby. We understand your sons are already settled. You don't have any specific reason to keep on working, but you are doing this just for the love of it. And if the love is to keep China away, I think that's an awesome reason to be existing.
Of course, I'm a net USD earner now, I can say that. Any material I'm importing, I'm exporting more than that.
Wow. I think that is really awesome. This would be one thing that we would probably be taking away from here. Okay. So now we're coming towards the end of the session. Sorry?
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
My pleasure, sir. It is really a pleasure to know more about you and especially how you've been taking this up. Okay, so now we're coming towards the end of this session. I'm sure you would be keen to know what is going to happen tomorrow. So tomorrow, Saturday, the session is going to happen at 9:30 in the morning. And as you know, we have been talking about Atmanirbhar Bharat, So tomorrow we are talking about Atmanirbhar, so getting Atmanirbhar digitally. The speaker tomorrow is a gentleman named Abhishek Jain, who is a specialist in organic digital marketing. Okay, he is a specialist in zero budget marketing, and he will be talking about some of the things that you can do yourself to promote your business online. It will definitely be an awesome session for you. Do join us tomorrow morning, 9:30. Okay. Sunday we will have Chopal. Monday is another interesting session. I don't remember who's the speaker right now, but we've got speakers lined up for the entire next week and the week after, and each one of them is a very interesting speaker. All right. Okay. See you then. See you tomorrow morning. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.